Okay, cherubs, this is the Eiffel Tower. You've seen it before, but right now I want you to imagine that you haven't. It's difficult, I know. This structure has been part of our cultural consciousness for a long time, and it's a visual synonym for its city and even its country. But let's go back to before 1889, before the Universal exhibit that debuted this structure, and look at it with fresh eyes. To do this effectively, we'll have to imagine ourselves at the epicenter of Impressionism, in a city that prides itself in its artistic talent, that sees itself as a center of culture. And then, in that city of culture and color and movement, this begins to rise. It's a metal behemoth, an expression of industrialism. Gustav Eiffel wasn't a sculptor or even an architect. He was an engineer, a bridge builder, and in a lot of ways, this looks like a bridge going straight up to the sky for no reason. If we keep our mental exercise going and view this through the lens of a city in love with its image as an artistic hub, this is ugly. It's nuts and bolts. It looks like a railway or an erector-set lighthouse. It's no wonder it has so many critics. My favorite, by the way, is Guy de Maupassant, who said that the French should, in some future riot, unbolt this tall, skinny pyramid of iron ladders, this giant and disgraceful skeleton, with a base that seems made to support a formidable monument of Cyclops and which aborts into a thin, ridiculous profile of a factory chimney. So good. That dude knew how to throw an insult. A less poetic critique of the tower was simply, what's the point? It's not pretty and it's not functional, then why? And honestly, that's a pretty good criticism. Eiffel's bridges were beautiful in part because they were useful, but this was impressive engineering for the sake of engineering. A lot of people just didn't get that. But here's the thing, if we're going to look at this with fresh eyes, we also need to imagine ourselves in a world where the Washington Monument is the world's tallest building. With those eyes, this is nearly twice as tall as the tallest man-made structure in the world. Whatever your aesthetic apprehensions may be, that's cool. And it was cool. It inspired awe in people. So is that the point? Is that enough of a point to justify the visual space that takes up? The amount of resources and man-hours it used? Those critics who felt as though feats of engineering needed to have a practical goal still lined up to see the city from that height. The pursuit of the seemingly useless inspired wonder, even in the naysayers, and that wonder could be a purpose in itself, so yeah, maybe the wow factor can be the point. Maybe it does justify itself. Just like the moon landing inspired future scientists, this no doubt inspired more than a few minds. Additionally, in order to reach this height, innumerable engineering problems that had never been confronted before had to be overcome. No elevator, for example, had ever traveled at an angle quite like this and under these constraints. The precision to have these four legs come to a completely level first landing and other similar tasks resulted in engineers developing new techniques. Eiffel didn't wait for a practical circumstance to confront these problems. He sought them out with this project and solved them with his team preemptively. So, in order to achieve new heights of knowledge, that pun is both intended and, I understand, boring, the people of Paris were asked to withhold their apprehensions and concerns for a brief time. As a result, the world realized that the awe, inspiration, and curiosity a painting can inspire can also be found on a piece of innovative engineering, that the imagination of an engineer is no less spectacular than that of a sculptor. The tower was only supposed to occupy this space for 20 years, but this lesson has proved more durable than that. And it's good to remind ourselves of this from time to time by looking at it with fresh eyes. If you like this video and feel I've earned it, please subscribe. I put out a new video every month. Thanks for watching.